Where was that picture?
What picture? I don't even know what I was sharing. I'm sorry.
Oh, it was gorgeous. I figured it was a picture you took on one of your trips.
It might have been, but I apologize. I don't even know which one it was. Anyway, again, I'm going to go ahead and mute everyone. We'll go just a little bit longer today. Soles of your feet together, knees out wide. Starting to connect with the breath. Breathing into a four count. Holding to a four count. And exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction from the tops of your throats, down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2.
Hard to hear you, Elizabeth.
4. And exhale. Okay, Bonnie.
I'm sorry.
That's fine. Thanks. 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. One more time, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual, and it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. Deep exhale.
Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Breathing into this simple twist, opening up those right obliques. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Wrap opposite elbows, rock back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Then grab your insteps, drag those knees down towards your shoulder blades, push up with your feet, pull down with your hands in happy baby. Maybe touching one knee and then the other to the mat. And then from here, draw those knees to center. As you inhale, exhale as you extend them above you, flex your feet, arms come up overhead, lower your legs to a 45 degree angle, inhale first, exhale as you draw those knees in, inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale back, exhale forward, inhale back, exhale forward, one more or six more of these wherever you are. Inhale back, exhale forward, inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Three more. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Again, slowly and with purpose. Exhale forward. Last one. Inhale back. And exhale forward. Good job. Wrap your arms around your knees. Rock back and forth. Place your feet as wide as the mat. Arms out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale down to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale down to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. And exhale to the right. Good job. Inhale those knees back to center. Draw them in. Give yourselves a hug. Exhale as you extend those legs down, roll over onto the left side. Left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale, that right knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, as you extend above you, drag that right shoulder back and down. And breathe. Again, this is infinity pose. Breathing in and out. Inhale that right knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side. Right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale. Extend. you drag that left shoulder back and down. Again, infinity pose. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale down. Draw your knees in. Place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again. Allowing each vertebrae to come back into alignment. And then arrive at the tops of your mats in Sukhasana. Simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. Extend your legs in front of you. Flex your feet. Good job. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach as far as you can. Place your hands on either side of your calves. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, down, chin to shin, and then just melt. Dandasana, staff pose. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale first. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale as you twist to the right as far as you can. Draw that left elbow down on the outside of your right knee. Open up. Make mudras with both fingers, both sets of fingers, and smile. Twisted Dandasana. Inhale all the way up. Exhale down. Inhale first. Exhale as you bend that left knee. Drawing your left heel to your sit bone. Flex that right foot. Inhale both arms up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach. Chin to shin, and then just curl in. Half Dandasana. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you draw that left knee to center. Good job. And then from here, place your left shoulder at the same height as your knee so that it's parallel to your knee. Reach back with your left arm. Reach back with your right arm. And then sit up straight. Opening up that whole right side. Breathing in and out. And smile. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Bend your elbow as you exhale, placing it on the outside of that left knee. Open up to the back of the room. Twisting, releasing toxins, massaging our internal organs. Good job. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend that leg. Draw your hands down. Good job. Inhale both arms all the way up. Twist to the left as you open up. Drawing that right elbow down on the outside of your left knee. Make a mudra with both sets of fingers and smile. Twisted Dandasana, breathing in and out. Good job, everyone. Inhale all the way back up again. Exhale as you draw those hands down. Inhale first. Exhale as you bend that right knee, drawing that right heel to your sit bone. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale as you hinge at the hips, fold forward, reach as far as you can, and then just melt. Half Dandasana. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you draw that right knee in. Draw your right shoulder towards your right knee. Reach back with your right arm. Reach back with your left arm. Keep that left foot flexed. And then sit up straight, dragging your shoulders back and down. Opening up as much as you can. Good job. Exhale forward. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Bend your elbow as you exhale, placing it on the outside of your right knee. Open up to the back of the room. Twisting, releasing toxins, massaging your internal organs. But you have to remember to breathe. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend your legs. Shake it out. Cross your legs in Sukhasana. Place your hands on the mat and roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Let's go ahead and walk those knees back, one hand's width. Inhale first. Exhale down to Balasana, child's pose. Maybe place your third eye on the mat, rock back and forth, massage your third eye. Inhale all the way through, dragging those hips down. Looking up towards the ceiling, shoulders back and down into Cobra. Good job. Exhale again. Back to Balasana. Opening up those spines. Opening up your hips. Inhale all the way through. Drag those hips down. Into Cobra. Shoulders back and down. Exhale all the way back. To Balasana. Last time. Inhale through, dragging those hips down, shoulders back and down, Cobra, and exhale back. Good job, everyone. So we're in table. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Walk those knees forward first so that they're directly underneath your hips. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Coming down on that right shoulder, keep your hips squared to the front of the room. Inhale that left arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that right hip crease. Good job. In thread the needle. Opening our hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that right arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale as you thread it under, coming down onto that left shoulder. Keep your hips squared to the front of the room. Inhale that right arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that left hip crease and breathe. Again, breathing in to thread the needle, opening our hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down. Good job. Curl your toes under. Sit back on your heels. Now you can either make infinity symbols with your wrists. Again, opening up those toes and your wrists. Or you can come up onto your toes as well. Hands are at Anjali Mudra in a balance. Again, again, opening those toes, opening your wrists, drawing those hands behind you possibly. Fingertips touch, pushing your fingers all the way up towards your crown of your head, interlacing your thumbs, opening those shoulders, and breathe. Job, everyone. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rock forward on your elbows. And then from here, plant those hands into the mat, curl your toes under. Exhale as you draw your hearts back towards your thighs. Flattening out your backs, lifting your tailbones up towards the heavens. Pressing that area between your index finger and thumb into the mat, taking the pressure off your wrists. In our first Ardha Mukha Shavasana, downward facing dog. Maybe walk the dog, come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, step or jump up, inhale halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Again, flat back, look towards the front of the room. Shoulders are back and down. Exhale down to Uttanasana, standing forward fold, maybe placing the palms of your hands on the mat. Inhale all the way up, swan dive backwards, hands come together. Slight back bend, and hands come to Anjali Mudra. I'm
going to adjust my screen very quickly, stay where you are.
Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. We're going to do three Surya Namaskar B, Sun Salutation B. No, let's do A, Sun Salutation A. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale halfway up to Ardha once again. And then step or jump back. So you can either step or you can jump back. Draw those elbows in. Inhale first. Exhale, chaturanga down. Inhale up to cobra. Exhale back to down dog. Good job. Come up on your tippy toes. Bend your knees. Step or jump up. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down to Uttanasana once again. Inhale all the way up, swan dive backwards, hands come together. And then exhale as you swan dive down. Inhale halfway up, step or jump back. Draw those elbows in. Exhale down, inhale up. To cobra or up dog. Exhale back to down dog. Walking the dog. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees. Step or jump up. Inhale up to Ardha. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Inhale all the way up, swan dive backwards, hands come together. Slight back bend, and hands come to Anjali Mudra. Good job, everyone. So from here, we're standing at the tops of our mats. Draw your toes together, knees together. We're moving into Utkatasana, chair pose. Inhale as you sit back in your chair. In Utkatasana, drawing that tailbone in as much as possible. Reaching up, pinky fingers in. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Twist out to the right, placing your left bicep on the outside of your right thigh. Good job. And then from here, look down, take a giant step back with that left foot. Good job. And then from here, open up north and south, twisting even more in revolved side angle. Take a wrap. Maybe take a bind, reach under and grab that right hand. Wringing ourselves out of all toxins. Good job. Inhale up. Look back towards the back of the room. And then spin out to Virabhadrasana 2. Check your back foot. It should be parallel with the front of the mat. Reach, 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 reach. As far as you can, palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Put your hands on your hips. Draw that left hip back, push that right hip forward. Float your hands back up again. Reach, 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 reach as far as you can. And then burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Look up, see your thumb. Make sure you're not torquing. Good job. Bend that front knee. Coming into side angle. Take a wrap. Maybe take a bind, reach under, grab that left wrist, dragging your left shoulder down towards the mat. Good job, everyone. Open up, north and south. Look down, inhale all the way up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel your arms down. Kick that right leg back. And go through your vinyasa or just meet us in down dog. Good job. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, step or jump up. Inhale, halfway up, the Ardha. Exhale, down to Uttanasana. Inhale, all the way up, swan dive backwards. Hands come together, slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Good job. Put your toes together, knees together. We're moving into Utkatasana again. On the left side, we're moving towards the left side. Inhale as you sit back in your chair. Drag those shoulders back and down. Tailbone in as much as possible. Look up towards the heavens. Hands come to Anjali Mudra. Twist out to the left side this time. Make sure that that right knee doesn't pop forward. Good job. Look down. Take a giant step back with that right foot. Open up, north and south. We're in revolved. Side angle. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind. Reach under and grab that left hand. Good job. Open up. East and west. towards the back of the room. Then spin out to Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Exhale back to center. Straighten that front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Drag that right hip back. Push your left hip forward. Float those hands up. Reach. And then burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Look up, see your thumb. Bend that front knee, opening up to side angle. Take a wrap, possibly take a bind, grab on to that right wrist. Drag your right shoulder down towards the mat. Open up, north and south. Look down, inhale all the way up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that left leg back, three-legged dog. And then exhale through your vinyasa or meet us in down dog. Either way is perfect. Good job. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Come up on your tippy toes. Bend your knees. Step or jump up. Inhale. Halfway up to Ardha. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backwards. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come onto Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Let's try some balance now. And today, since it's Friday, let's try stork to standing splits. Again, it doesn't have to be beautiful. Just do to whatever your ability is. I'm going to move back just a little so you can see the tops of my hands. All four corners of your feet should be growing into the earth. Lift your toes. We're in Tadasana. Open those arms. Your hands are open to receive. Good job. Calf muscles moving inward. Thighs are moving in. Pelvis down the back. Abdomen is in. Our shoulders are back and down. And the crowns of our heads are moving towards the heavens. Again, hands open to receive. In Tadasana, mountain pose. Feel that mountain within you. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on your right tippy toes. Inhale that right knee into a marching position. Flex your foot. And then inhale those arms all the way up overhead into stork. Good job. Keep gazing at your drishti or your focal point. Exhale, as you fold forward, hinge at the hips, drawing that right leg behind you and extend it into standing splits. Good job, it doesn't have to be pretty, as I said. Inhale all the way back up again, into stork. Exhale down. As far as you can into standing splits, lifting that leg behind you. Inhale all the way back up again into stork. And then last time, Exhale down into standing splits. Maybe even grab on to your ankle and draw yourselves in if that's in your practice. Inhale all the way back up again. Stork, good job. Draw those hands to the Utthita. Inhale first. Exhale down. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Inhale first. And exhale down to the mat. Good job. Okay, that's one of the hardest balances we can do. So good job. And again, it doesn't have to be pretty. We're gonna do the other side now, starting in Tadasana, Mountain Pose. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on those left tippy toes. Inhale that left knee up, flex your foot. We're in a marching position. Inhale those arms up overhead. Into stork, pinky fingers in, gazing at our drishti. Exhale down. Hinge at the hips. Draw that left leg up behind you in standing splits. Inhale all the way back up again. Again, it doesn't have to be pretty. Exhale down. Lifting that left leg behind you, standing splits. Inhale all the way up into a marching position. Exhale down. And then one last time, inhale all the way back up again. Into stork again. Getting there as best you can. Draw your hands to the Utthita as you inhale. Exhale down. Once again, inhale first. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Good job. Shake it out. Perfect. Coming up to the tops of our mats. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swung arm down. Inhale halfway up. Take a giant step back with that left foot. Right foot walks all the way across to the left. Right knee down, left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Maybe take Venus Mudra. Exhale down. Coming down on that left cheek. In resting pigeon. Again, you can also be on your back. Bending that right knee. Placing your right heel just below your left knee. Interlacing your fingers around that left thigh, drawing it in, opening up your right hip as well. Wherever you are is perfect. Again, we're releasing any unwanted emotions that we may be storing on that right hip. Breathing in and out in resting pigeon. Inhale as you walk those hands back, but don't come off on that left hip yet. Excuse me, right hip. Bend your left knee. Place your left elbow around your ankle and open up mermaid by taking a bind, if this is in your practice, opening up your hearts, slowly release, come up on that right hip. Swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find that right hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Mariandrasana twist. Breathing in and out. And smile, it's Friday. Good job, everyone. Slowly inhale to center. Stack your knees. Place the blades of your feet on the mat. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach. And then just melt, opening up that left sciatic nerve. Cow space, breathing in and out. Inhale, as you walk those hands back again, press into the mat with your hands and the blades of your feet. Extend your legs, inhale first. Exhale as you walk your hands all the way around to the right in a 360-degree circle. Cross your knees, knees down, hips down, sit up straight. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach. All the way down. Opening up that right sciatic nerve. Inhale as you walk your hands back again. Again, press into the mat with your hands and the blades of your feet. Extend your legs, inhale first. Exhale to the left, walking in a 360-degree circle with your hands. You're on the balls of your feet, cross your knees, knees down, hips down, sitting up straight in cow space. Good job, let's come up to the tops of our mats. To Malasana, yogi squat, again. The backs of our biceps are just below our knees. If you'd like to, place your hands just beyond the mat. Rock back and forth. Coming in to Bakasana or Crow Pose, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Coming back to Malasana. Stay where you are. I'm just going to make sure that my phone is on silent. And in Malasana, inhale from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra and exhale down again. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Good job. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back. Put that right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. Left knee down. Right knee down. Right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back to Royal Pigeon. Take Venus Mudra if this is in your practice. Exhale down, placing that right cheek on the mat this time. Good job, in resting pigeon. Again, you can be on your backs as well. You can be up on your elbows. Wherever you are is perfect. Opening up that left hip, releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there. Breathing in and out. In resting pigeon. Slowly inhale as you walk those hands back. Bend that right knee. Wrap your right arm around your ankle. Open up to swan if this is in your practice. Or possibly into mermaid by taking a bind. Slowly release. Come off on that left hip. Swing that right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that right foot in, that right elbow in. Inhale that, bring that left foot in, that left elbow in. Sorry, I'm having a hard time today. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find that left hip crease. Maybe take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Mariandrasana twist. Breathing in and out. Good job, everyone. Slowly inhale back to center. Stretch out your legs, shake them out. Bend your knees. Arms are out on either side. Inhale as you draw those feet up. Flex them, grab onto your toes, and then extend if this is in your practice. You can stay where you are as well. Drag those shoulders back and down as much as possible. Breathing in and out in this boat pose modification. This balance, coming back. Extend your legs in front of you, open up those arms. Maybe point your toes. Coming back again, you can either place the soles of your feet on the mat or stay with us. Inhale first, exhale inch by inch, vertebrae by vertebrae down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Make sure that you have your block handy. Place your heels just below your sit bones. Inhale as you push those hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, the second or the third levels. Again, this is a place that you can either do the supported bridge, you can do a regular bridge, you can do a wheel if that's in your practice, if you feel like you'd like to do that. Opening up that lower back, breathing in and out. Again, you can move into a T formation or a mushroom formation if you're in a supported bridge, if that feels good. Walk out those feet, draw your arms overhead, and then draw your arms beside your torso. Walk your feet in, inhale as you push your hips up, release the block, and exhale down. Draw your knees in for a hug. Moving in to a shoulder stand or just legs straight up, allowing the circulation to come back down to our vital organs. back down to our brains. You can stay here. You can follow us, pushing those hips up, walking your shoulders under as much as you can in a shoulder stand. Possibly draw those toes overhead in halasana or plow pose. Maybe grab your toes. Possibly bend your knees, placing them around your ears in ear pressure pose. And then inch by inch, vertebrae by vertebrae, coming down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Let's go ahead and do one more twist before we extend our legs into Shavasana. Cross that right leg over left. Wrap your feet. Arms are out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale as your knees fall down to the left. Look over the right shoulder. Inhale back to center. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. And then cross that left leg over right. Wrap your feet, arms out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale down to the right. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Inhale back to center. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. One more time. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out. Inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground. Starting to connect with the breath. Starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads, relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead. Extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, up back to a seated position, facing the front of the room, legs are crossed. Hands are at Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of our practices. from the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true. I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Friday. Have a wonderful weekend. Happy Mother's Day to everyone. Namaste. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful rest of the day. Great weekend.
You too.
Have a great weekend, everybody. Thanks,
Lou.
A lovely Mother's Day.